Week in, week out, I see these videos all over social media of people's bikes being stolen up and down the country. And while people are spending more money on locks for their bikes,
a tracker is essential, especially for me as a delivery rider when I'm out here in the city where 60 bikes are stolen a day in London. And I've been using an Apple AirTag for the last year and a half, and it has finally died. And that is why I have linked up with Backpedal, who have state-of-the-art trackers, and they also have their own bike hunters. So if your bike is ever stolen, you ring up their 24/7 phone line, which I'm about to do now, and they will send out some of their recovery agents to find your bike. I want to put it to the test. I had a Backpedal tracker installed in this bike 2 days ago, and we're going to see how precise it is and how good they are at tracking down bikes. Oh my God, no way. That was quick.
Thanks for calling Backpedal. Please note that this call may be recorded for training and monitoring purposes. Press 1 to report a theft. Press 2 yes. to talk to our customer.
My bike's been nicked. I'm fuming.
Hi, this is Jack at Backpedal. How can I help?
Hello there. It's London Eats. I had one of your trackers installed in my bike the other day, and I've just had it nicked in Westminster. And I wanted to see if you could try and recover it.
Recovery agents are on their way.
All right. Now, let's see how good their trackers are. I'm going to get on the bike now and get out of here because I know they're going to be on it straight away. So let's get on the bike and head up into central London where it's super, super busy. Now, I was going to do some deliveries whilst they're trying to track me down, but the last thing I want is to be stuck at a restaurant and then they roll up and that's it. The video is over. So I want to make it as difficult as possible for them. I just want to keep moving around. I'm going to be heading up towards Victoria now, as it is quite a congested place. And then we can head over to Soho where there is thousands and thousands of people. Yeah, I just want to test how accurate the GPS tracker is. I've seen their recovery videos on Instagram, and being a customer now myself, I want to see if it's up to standard and how long it takes for them to actually track me down. And it is quite nerve-wracking them trying to hunt me down. So fingers crossed they don't get me really, really fast. It is absolutely freezing. Woohoo! Winter is nearly here. Now, obviously, when your bike is stolen, it is normally locked up somewhere in a garage or someone's house, and it's very rarely on the move unless they're out stealing more bikes with your bike. And as I said in the beginning of this episode, over 60 bikes a day are stolen in London, and thousands more across the UK. And a tracker is, I think, one of the most essential pieces of kit when you buy an expensive e-bike. This e-bike that I'm sitting on now cost £1,800. But when you spend that kind of money on an e-bike, the last thing you want is some scruff to just steal it. Road closed ahead. I don't know if I can go through there. So we're gonna chuck a right. Ooh, it is busy up here.
Getting any updated signals.
Now we've got Lewis Hamilton. All right, now we are in the heart of London, Piccadilly Circus. Thousands and thousands of people around here right now. Very easy to blend in. Should we head down Regent Street? Maybe, yeah. Wakey wakey, rise and shine. Yeah, they're never gonna find me here. They are never gonna find me down Regent Street.
We'll just go and hunt them down on this live location.
Right, so to get close, let's go to, I'm gonna take us to Piccadilly Circus.
Where is it?
Oh mate, we'll be there in 10 minutes.
Even have time to stop for a coffee maybe, who knows. the thieves stop for coffees. And with this tracker as well, there is a backup tracker. If the thief finds your main tracker and disconnects it, there is a small tracker that is put on the bike as well, which is called a sleeper, and that activates. Literally impossible to find. The only person that knows where it is the person that installed it, which is another really great feature. I don't want to get crushed by this bus. So if you look on your screen right now, you'll be able to see exactly where I am, and that is what they will be seeing on their device, whatever they use to track down stolen bikes. But we're heading up towards Oxford Street, which is even more busier than Regent Street. By the way, peeps, this is Jack, one of my best pals, and he's come along with me today because he is interested in getting the tracker for his bike as well.
Your bike
was stolen recently, no? Wait.
Yeah, about 2 months.
2 months ago, yeah. Managed to get it back, luckily. All right, coffee shop. I can see a Pret. Is Pret open at this time? No, of course they're not. I'm just worried. I just feel like they're going to be around here somewhere. Thank you. All right, coffee secured. I think what I'm gonna do is try and find a side street that's really quiet.
Well, I think we're gonna get there and he's gonna move.
Finished my coffee, now it's time to get back on the move. I don't want to keep moving around too much because at the end of the day, it's going to take them hours to find me. So I might find a little side street somewhere that's a little bit like off track, somewhere where they wouldn't expect me to be, because there is a lot of little hidden alleys in central London, and I think that would be a good spot to see how strong that GPS tracker really is. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna head up towards this way. I don't even know where I'm going right now. I don't know what it is. I feel like they're close. Yes. I feel like they're close by. Back streets of London. Ooh, that looks like a good spot. That's a good spot. Let's go there. Look, there's even drug deals going on down there. or a multi-story car park. That would be a good spot. Is there any in central London? Probably not. Every bicycle I see now, I'm like, is that them?
That should be homing in.
We are, I think we're close to Tottenham Road.
Yeah.
Oh my God, no way.
Got him.
No way, got him, man. Just as I'm...
That's the one, him away.
Oh, there's two of you. What the hell? Okay, I'll give you that. I thought I was gonna get rugby tackled
easy,
or something.
Easy.
But
no.
Okay.
No on street violence.
I think they deserve it though. White peeps deserve it. I weren't expecting it to take long, but that was impressive.
It's just, this was quick, but like, it can take time as well. Like, it can take us hours sometimes, and like, people can go in buildings and like, you lose it for a bit, they come back out and you're waiting and you're...
Yeah,
it pops back up again. So
I knew it was going to be quick, but not that quick. All right, so I'm super impressed with the GPS tracking provided by Backpedal. The reason why I got it is because, like I said, my Apple AirTag died and I felt like I needed something a little bit more reliable. And with the service of the recovery team to go out and get your bike, that's one of the main reasons as well. I'm a very, very busy person, and like I said, the dangers of trying to recover your bike nowadays is very high, and you do put yourself at risk. How can people get started with a tracker? What do they need to do?
Yeah, so visit our website, backpedal.co. You can look at different types of trackers on there. We've got a simple one that just gets hidden away on your bike, doesn't need connecting into any electronics or anything else like that.
And if you're interested in getting a tracker yourself, I'll leave a link in the description below this video, and there will be an exclusive promo code. Look forward to not the next one. I don't want my bike to get nicked.
Yeah.
But yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next episode.